Yesterday, we were discussing about what? Ruchi and Pidya? Motion in a straight line, that motion under gravity. Okay. First case, two, it was taken in two cases. One is the object is moving up. We found time of flight, time of ascent, then maximum height reached, and velocity with which it is drawn. Yes. Okay. What is the equation for time of ascent? U by G. Okay. What is the velocity at maximum height? Zero. What is the initial, if the object travels height h upward, then what is the velocity, initial velocity, what's the initial velocity? Yeah. No, an object is thrown vertically up with some velocity u. It reaches a maximum height h. Then what's the value of initial velocity in terms of h and g? U square, final velocity will be zero. So zero is equal to u square minus 2gh. So u will be equal to root of 2gh. Correct. Second case, we were discussing the object is dropped from a certain height. Okay. Its initial velocity is zero and acceleration is downward is taken as positive. Displacement downward is taken as positive. The final velocity with which it reaches the ground is root of 2gh. Okay. Time of descent is v by g. Okay. Total time of flight. Time of flight, I mean, object is moving up, which is the maximum height, are coming back to the same point. The total time of flight is taken as 2u by g. Correct. Yes. Now, an object of mass m is dropped from certain height h. Tell me, what will be the distance traveled in first to second? Distance traveled in first second?
5 meter.
Yeah, 5 meter. What is the equation for that? How to find out? We can use the equation S is equal to ut plus half gt square. Initial velocity is zero. S is half gt square. Okay, generally S1 is half gt square. Tell me, what is the displacement traveled in 2 seconds? Total displacement traveled in 2 seconds?
10 meters.
Yeah. Half into g into t is 2 square. Here half g t square, that is half g. Here half into g into 2 square. T is 2 square. It is, it will be 4 by 2, 2. 2 into 10. 2g. Yes or no? I am writing in terms of g. 4 by 2, 2, 2 into g. So tell me, what is the displacement traveled in 3 seconds? Half into g into
15 meters.
3 square. Okay. That is equal to 4.5 g. Continuous like that. Okay. You find the ratio of S1 is to S2 is to S3. Estagutte. It is like 0.5 is to 2 is to 4.5 anta bandu. Stella ratio. Or as I can write as 1 is to 4 is to 9. Saripoda? Multiply throughout by 2. Still sigutte. 1 is to 4 is to 9. Okay. You see, if you think about the time, t is equal to 1 here, t is equal to 2 second, t is equal to 3 second here. That means distance traveled in consecutive time interval. I mean, distance traveled by the object in the consecutive time is S1 is to S2 is equal to S3 is equal to is in the ratio of square of their time. Okay, t1 is 1 square, t2 is 2, is 2 square, is 3 square. Okay, so when an object is dropped from a certain height h, the distance traveled in the consecutive seconds or time will be in the ratio of the square of the time. Okay, initially time is 1 second and later total distance is 2 second, total time is 2 second, total time is 3 second. So ratio of the displacement traveled in first second, first second, second second, and third second is 1:2. I mean 1 square is 2, 2 square is 2, 3 square. Okay, fine. Need to write down this, right? Write down. Down an object of mass m. An object of mass m is dropped from certain height h. The ratio of the total displacement traveled, ratio of total displacement traveled in first second, once in 1 second, comma 2 second, and 3 second is 1:4:9. Ratio of total displacement traveling in 1 second, 2 second, and 3 second is the ratio 1:4:9. Okay. So in 1 second, total may travel some distance. Yes. In 2 second, square of that total distance is square of that distance. A 3 second, 3 square. Okay. Yesterday we have discussed one equation, the displacement of an object in nth second. What's the formula for that? Displacement of the object in nth second. It is u plus
half a into
a by 2 into
2n minus 1,
2n minus 1, or a into n minus 1 by 2. Displacement traveled by an object in the nth second is u plus a into n minus 1 by 2. Displacement traveled by an object in the nth second is u plus a into n minus 1 by 2. Okay. If I write this equation in terms of a freely falling body, the displacement traveled in the nth second, of a body during its free fall from a height h, right on. Displacement traveled by an object. During the nth second of its free fall. During the nth second of its free fall is u plus, instead of a it is g, n minus 1 by 2. U plus g into n minus 1 by 2. If the initial velocity is u, if u is equal to 0, if the initial velocity is 0, then displacement traveled in the nth second will be g into n minus 1 by 2. G into 1 minus 1 by 2. Written? No, write down. Consider an object of mass m. Consider an object of mass m is dropped from a height h. Stop. The ratio of the displacement traveled, the ratio of the displacement traveled in the first to second, comma, second second, comma, third second is. You're going to find that. Okay. The question, an object is dropped from a certain height. Okay. In first to second, that means time is equal to 1 second. For first to second, displacement travel is this much. When time is 2 seconds, that means from here, the displacement of object will be from here to here. Total displacement is from here to here. Point A, from A to B is the time displacement in first second. A to C is the displacement in total 2 seconds. But here you are asked to find the ratio of displacement traveled in first to second and displacement traveled in second. What is it? Displacement traveled in first second. A to B. What is the displacement traveling second? B to C. Okay. And if time, when distance, displacement traveling the third second will be in 3 seconds. Total displacement is from A to D. Displacement traveled in the third second is from C to D. You need to find the ratio. Okay. You tell me, what is the total displacement traveled in 1 second? S is equal to half g, t is 1, g by 2. Correct? What is the total displacement traveled in second? Half into g into 2 square, 4. That is 2g. Correct? Total displacement from A to B is G by 2. Total displacement from A to C is 2G. Correct. You tell me, what is the displacement traveled in second? 2G minus G by 2 is 2. 3G by 2. Correct. Now tell me, what is the total displacement in 3 seconds? Half g into 3 square, 9. That is equal to 9/2 g. Total displacement from A to D is 9/2 g. So tell me, what is the displacement traveled in third second? 9/2 g minus is to total displacement. 2g is to do 9g minus 4g by 2, 5g by 2. Correct. So you tell me, what's the ratio of, you wrote that, no, ratio of the displacement traveled in first to second and third second. That is equal to ratio is AB is to BC is to C. That is equal to G by 2 is to 3, G by 2 is to 5, G by 2 is 1 is to 3 is to 5. Goes like that. 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7. Goes like that. Okay. Understood? Ganesh? And here is so these are some general cases you need to remember always. Okay. They may now some tricky cases where they'll be asking you some questions, but we don't have to work out. We can just think and answer. Okay, such some examples related to that. No object is draw. Huh? Ah, switch on. Agree, bro. Off, Aita. Leave it, no. An object is dropped from a point A. What's the velocity with which it reaches the ground? If height is h, you tell me what's the velocity with which it reaches the ground. Root of 2gh. Okay. Now, from the same height h, okay, one object is thrown vertically up with the velocity u. From the same height h, an object is thrown vertically up with velocity u. Let it swell. And the other object is thrown vertically down with velocity u. One object is thrown up with velocity u. Other object is thrown down with velocity u. Okay. You tell me, when it reaches the ground, which one will have the highest velocity? First object or second object? Or both will have same velocity? An object is thrown vertically up with the velocity u. Another is thrown vertically down with the velocity u. On reaching the ground, which one will have more velocity? First object will have more velocity, or second object will have more velocity, or both will have the same velocity? You are telling first object have more velocity u. First one will have more velocity u. Both will same. Yes. See, think. Now consider only the first object. Okay. When it is going up, its velocity is u. Okay. It goes up, reaches the maximum height. What's the velocity?
Zero.
Correct? From here, goes down, reaches this point. What will be its velocity? U. Same velocity. Initially, it was going up, but when it, after reaching maximum height, it reaches the same point. There it have the same velocity u. What's the direction? Down. Now consider second object. What was second object's initial velocity? U. Downwards. Now first object's initial velocity from this point will be u. Both will reach ground with same velocity, because initially when it is in downward motion, both have same velocity at the same point. Displacement it has to travel is same. Acceleration is same. So here it goes up with velocity u. At maximum height, its velocity is zero. Yes.
From there it is dropping down.
Yeah, it is dropping down, zero, dropping down. When it reaches the same height, its velocity is the velocity with which it is projected up, u. What was the velocity with which it is coming down, u? At this point, is first second object's velocity is u downward. What is first object's velocity when it is coming down? U. So when it reaches the ground, both will have the same velocity. Okay. Write down. Did you write the question? No. Write down. Two objects, A and B. Two objects A and B are thrown from a height h. in such a way that now object A is thrown vertically up. Object A is thrown vertically up with the velocity u. Thrown from a height h in such a way that the object A is thrown vertically up with a velocity u, and the object B is thrown vertically down with a velocity u. On reaching the ground, both will have the same velocity. Put it under in a box. You can always think of it. Okay. When we discuss about motion in a plane, along with this case, there will be another object thrown horizontally. Okay. That's okay. Fine. Clear? Clear? Now you tell me, which object will take more time to reach ground, A or B, or both will have same time? A is thrown vertically up with velocity B is thrown vertically down with velocity B. Time taken at the same time, we will reach. Okay, when two objects A and B, when they are thrown in such a way that A is thrown up with velocity u and B is thrown down with velocity u, okay, then time taken by B is less than time taken by A, right there itself. In this case, time taken by the object B will be less than the time taken by the object A. Next question. An object of mass m is dropped from a height h. If t1 is the time taken to cover the first half of the distance, and t2 is the time taken to cover the second half of the distance, and t2 is the time taken to cover the second half of the distance. Then option A, t1 is t2, b t1 is less than t2, c t1 is greater than t2, d t1 is equal to 2t2. ಹೇಗೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡುದು? Salvi, you tell me which are the questions, which options are possible to be right? You tell me which of the options are possible to be right. Exact answer beda nanage, at least chances yavade answer chance ide. T2 is greater than T1, hoda? Which can be right on the, at least on the assumption, which can be neglected, which option can be neglected, you tell me. Think. Distance traveled in first T1 is equal to distance traveled in T2. Both distances are same, correct? Tell me, initially s2 velocity there, u is equal to 0. Travel some distance and reached here with velocity. Let the point be A, let the point be B, let the point be C. At B, it is having velocity V. Now it has to reach C, correct? Now, distance traveled, S, how will you write? S is equal to UT plus half AT square. UT is 0. Plus half A is G, T1 square. Now, the same distance. This is also same distance. For second case, distance traveled, S is equal to, what is initial velocity? VT2 plus half G T2 square. Correct? Yes or no? For second half of the motion, initial velocity is V. It reached here. So initial velocity is V. Okay? Distance traveled, it has traveled the same. If you equate this, what you get? Half G T1 square is equal to VT2 plus half G T2 square. Yes or no? From this, which is more? T1 or T2, which is more? Or both are same. If I write that half G with T1 square is half G T2 square, T1 is equal to T2. Agidya? Half G T1 square is greater than half G T2 square. Yes or no? Half, from this it is clear that half G T1 square is greater than half G T2 square. Yes or no? Half G T1 square is something plus half G T2 square. Correct? Yes. That means what? Half G T1 square, this term is greater than this term. Very simple. A is equal to B plus C. Can I write that A is greater than C? Yes. Yes. Similarly, A is equal to B plus C. A is greater than C. That means what? T1 is greater than T2. That is possible. T1 is greater than T2. T1 is greater than T2. Now I need to check whether T1, what is the relation between T1 and T2? Obviously, T1 is greater than T2. Now I need to check the relation between T1 and T2. It may be right, may not be right, and I don't know now. I need to check. Understood this one? Bataita? Sure. Then you smile. Okay. Now, did you write this? Very big. Right. Bataita? And if you check, you will get that T1 is not equal to 2T2. If you check, you get that T1 is not equal to T2. You can substitute, and we may have to go for, I mean, you will, if you write the value of V is equal to GT1. Starting from U equal to 0, T1 time V is equal to U plus AT. 0 plus GT1. if you substitute, you will not get this relation. You will not get this relation. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, this is wrong. This is wrong. So option C, T1 is greater than T2, is correct. Okay. Can I erase? Now a question or situation. An object is dropped from a height h. An object is dropped from a height h. Okay. So what is its initial velocity? U is equal to zero. What is its acceleration? Plus g. For only for this object. Downward. I take positive only. Displacement traveled. S is, let it be y. Displacement traveled is y downward. Okay. At the same time, when it is dropped, at the same time, another object of same mass is thrown up with a velocity u. Another object of same mass is thrown up with a velocity u. What is its acceleration? Actually, the object is thrown up, acceleration is down. So it is minus g. Okay. And if total height is h, the total height is h. Now, for a given time interval t, or after a time interval t, it is said that both are meeting at the same point, or both crosses a particular point at same time t. You can say somewhere here or here. From this, I mean this distance is y. Okay. After a time t, this object reaches here, this object reaches here. That means they cross each other after a time interval t. Do you get the situation? They cross each other after a time interval t. Okay. Then, if y is the displacement traveled by the first one, what is the displacement traveled by the second one? This distance will be h minus y. Displacement traveled is h minus y. Yes. Now let's try to solve what is that. So for first object, displacement traveled y is equal to s is equal to ut plus half gt square. U is zero. So y is equal to half gt square for first object. Yes. Okay. Equation number one. For second object, what is the displacement traveled? H minus y, positive, positive axis. So h minus y is equal to initial velocity is u. Ut minus half g t square. T minus half g t square. Equation number two. It's y is equal to half gt square. H minus y is equal to ut minus half gt square. Okay. Now h minus y. So you have the two equation. Now if you have the initial velocity u, time after which they meet, you can find out h or you can find out y value. If you have initial velocity u, or if you have that, I mean time, if the time is given t, then you can find out the distance traveled or the point where they meet. You can find out. Clear? For example, they are giving that an object is dropped from a height h, and the same time t, another object is thrown vertically up. Okay. With a velocity 20 meter per second or something. And they say that if they meet at a point after 2 seconds, if they meet at a point after 2 seconds, then find the value of h. You can find out from these two equations. Correct? Are you getting the point? for first object u is zero, acceleration is positive, distance traveled is y, then I can write y is equal to half gt square. Correct. For second object, initial velocity is u, and they meet at a height h minus y after time t. Then I can write h minus y is equal to ut minus half gt square. Have two equations, right? Now, in a given problem, if they say that two objects, one is dropped from a height h, and at the same time, another is thrown vertically up with a velocity 20 meter per second. That means what? You have u value is given in the problem. And if they say that they meet at a point t, they meet at a point after 2 seconds, mean t value is given, u value is given, then find the height of the building. How to find out? If t is given and u is given, h minus y is equal to u into t minus half into gt square. H minus y you can find out, okay? And y is equal to half gt square. Y you can find out. So h minus y plus y is h. Can find out h. Getting the point? Yes. Fine. Want to? Did you write this? Write down. Two objects are moving under gravitational field. There two objects are moving under gravitational field in such a way that an object is thrown vertically up with the velocity u, and at the same time another object is dropped from a height h. Another object is dropped from a height h. They cross each other after a time t. Across each other after a time t. Then the distance traveled by the first object, comma, y is equal to distance traveled by the first object, comma, y is equal to half gt square. Question number one. Second, the distance traveled by the second object comma h minus y distance traveled by the second object h minus y is equal to ut minus half gt square. Ut minus half gt square. Come on. Full stop. Under that you write. In such situation, in such situation, if initial velocity u and time t is given, if initial velocity u and time t is given, comma, the height of the first mass m, height of the second mass m from the ground can be calculated.
పేపర్ ఉడన్ పీస్ కరెక్ట్ ఫైవ్ మినిట్స్ ఉంది త్రీ ఫోర్ కాన్సెప్చువల్ క్వశ్చన్స్
అయితా ఈజీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కాన్సెప్చువల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఓకే లైక్ వాట్ వీ డిడ్ యెస్టర్డే సో సో ఫార్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ ఎస్టు తనక ఎస్ట్ ఆగిదే ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ మోషన్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ దెన్ ఆవరేజ్ వెలోసిటీ instantaneous velocity, average speed, instantaneous speed, then acceleration, then displacement time graph, velocity time graph, then motion under gravity when it is going up and when it is coming down, okay, and some specific cases like this. Okay, now keeping all these things in mind, write the question. Which of the following can be zero, comma, when a particle is in motion for some time. Some conceptual questions only. I don't discuss problems with lengthy solution. Okay, just conceptual. Which of the following can be zero, comma, when a particle is in motion for some time? Option A, speed. Option B, displacement. Option C, distance. Option D, none of these. Speed, displacement, distance, none of these. This place. Why? If the particle is in motion for some time, speed cannot be zero, distance cannot be zero, but displacement can be zero. If the particle reaches back to the same point, displacement can be zero, velocity also can be zero. Okay. Next question, write down. Check up only the correct statement in the following. Option A, a body has a constant velocity and still it can have a varying speed. Option A. Option B, a body has a constant speed but can have a varying velocity. Body has a constant speed but can have a varying velocity. Third one,
A body having constant speed, body having constant speed cannot have a cannot have any acceleration. Cannot have any acceleration. Option D, none of these. First one, agata, agalla. If velocity is constant, then speed is constant. Second question, speed is given constant, velocity is not constant, varying. Agate, yavaga. When velocity is a vector, velocity has both magnitude and direction. If for a velocity, if speed is constant, okay, it can, and it can have a varying velocity. How? The magnitude of velocity, if it is constant, then speed is constant, but direction of velocity can be changed. In that case, I can say its speed is constant, but it has a velocity. For example, an object moving in a circular path, uniform circular motion, speed constant is there, 2 meters per second. Suppose the object is moving around a circular path in 2 meters per second, the speed is constant, but velocity is different in different point. Why? Direction of velocity is different, so velocity is different. So second one can be correct. Second one can be correct. Third one, check. Third one. A body having constant speed cannot have any acceleration. Can have acceleration. Same. Circular motion, uniform circular motion. Speed is constant. Acceleration is the law. What is the direction of acceleration? Towards center. Centripetal acceleration. So, if the speed is constant, it can have acceleration. Acceleration perpendicular agi because time. Speed and acceleration should be perpendicular, or the velocity at that point of time and acceleration should be perpendicular. Then its speed is constant. Pataita, circular motion, acceleration is towards center. Speed is constant. Okay. And fourth one. So second one is correct. Okay. Next question. For a uniform motion, option A. Velocity time graph is a straight line. Velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis. Option B. Position time graph is a parabola. See, the acceleration time graph, AT graph, is a straight line. AT graph is a straight line inclined with the time axis. Inclined with time axis. Option D. Position time graph is a circle. Think and tell me. First option. So what is given? For uniform motion. Uniform motion means what? Definition of uniform motion. Object covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Okay. Object covers equal distance in
equal interval of time. Now let me write the position, draw the position diagram. Okay, if it is parallel to x-axis, enagutte, it is at rest. Okay, if it is like this, the OD covers equal distance in equal interval of time. It's a straight line. If position time graph is a straight line, that means the object is covering equal distance in equal interval of time or for uniform motion. Position time graph. Did they give about the position time graph? They are telling position time graph is a parabola. So that option is wrong. Now let's draw velocity time graph. Time, velocity. Uniform motion means what? Velocity is constant throughout, or the object covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Velocity is constant. That means it is parallel to time axis. Velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis. So first option is correct. Okay. Okay. So we'll see on Tuesday, Monday. I mean, not be available. Okay. So I hope those are online. It is clear, and we'll see on Monday or Tuesday. Okay. Take care.